Hey guys, this is Raibix, and I'm here with my official playthrough for all of you of Fallout New Vegas. As a lot of you know, it is my absolute all-time favorite game, so I'm super pumped to be able to share it with you, and especially with a bunch of people having hype recently because Fallout 4 is coming out. This, if you haven't played any of the games, will at least kind of give you an introduction to the universe that it's set in and some of the stuff that goes on.
Changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business, under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling, must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck. Truth is, the game was rigged from the start.
All right, guys. So welcome to Fallout New Vegas. That is your intro to the game. So as you can see, you've met Benny, who will be one of our main characters and the love of my life. So here's to hoping we're going to be seeing a lot more of him real quick. So I've played a lot of the different endings and I know a lot of how everything works out, but I'm not quite sure how I want this playthrough to go. So as you're watching, if you have any suggestions or anything like that you'd like me to go through and do, just leave them down in the comments, send a message, something, and that way I'll know what you guys kind of want to see in this. We'll definitely be hitting all of the DLC, though. That is definitely on my hit list for this, but let's get started up. Can you tell me your name? My name is not Courier. We're gonna be Rye for this game. You know what? You're kind of being rude, sir. I've got a good name. Character customization. And I'm gonna play a lady. Typically speaking, when I play Fallout, I usually play as a dude, so I think it'll be fun to play as a chick this time around. Get some high cheekbones up in this bitch. And have them be pronounced. Cheekbones are kinda my favorite in the universe. Let's go for a hairstyle. Now, as nice as Wendy the Welder is, let's go for Prim and Proper is not so good. Domestic Goddess. No, we are going to stick with Wendy the Welder, I think. That works for me. It's totally my character. Oh yeah, you did fine. You just kind of recreated me as a dude to begin with, but you know, same diff. Well, I think you Vertigo. Actually, it is a race. It is a race to kill Benny. That's pretty much what the plot of this game is for anybody who didn't pick up on that. There we go. Alright, so let's pick some traits here. For strength, since I want to play this character as myself, I am the wimpiest wimp to ever exist. Like, I'm not sure. I'm somewhere between a beached jellyfish and a dough baby. Or a doughy baby. I wish that I could have doomsday pecs, though, you know what I mean? So we'll go for dough baby, just so I'm not totally screwed when I go to play later. Perception, I am fairly perceptive, so let's see, should I go for big-eyed tiger or alert coyote? Let's go for a tiger. Endurance, I am definitely either, I'm fairly flexible, but handle with care. Please handle me with care. No, that's not what I wanted. Okay, charisma. I am a regular Casanova, if you haven't already told. Alright, I should just go for cult leader, but that's probably saying a bit too much. Look out for movie star. Intelligence. Let's see. I'm probably gifted. I'd like to say smarty pants, but I know that I'd be lying. Agility. I am a Butterfinger. I'm not even a Butterfinger. I'm like somewhere in the middle, so under control. We'll go for the middle ground here. And luck. Lucky 7. I'm fairly lucky. I've got tons of stories on that one. Like how I still have Amazon Prime when I'm not the one paying for it. Lucky me, I guess? I don't know. Let's go for that one, though. Alright, so this is our character. It me. It's as me as it's ever gonna get. I look so unimpressed with everything.
I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing.
Alright, let's do it.
Dog.
Cat.
House.
None of these. Let's go for burglar eyes. Day. Okay, that's not in there. Shroud.
Bandit.
Douchebag. Step. Light. Sure, why not? Dark.
Mother.
Let's see. Human shield. That is a beautiful answer, but it's not the one I'm going for because that doesn't stand true to me. Caretaker. I have a pretty hella relationship with my mom, so we'll go honest here.
Okay. Now, I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something.
Let's do it.
First one, conflict just ain't in my nature.
Meh. No opinion. Depends on what the topic is.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
Way too true.
I'm always fixing to be the center of attention.
I bet all of you guys already know that I'm pretty in love with me, and all of you should be too, so strongly agree.
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
Not really. Disagree.
I charge in to deal with my problems.
Not at all!
Almost done here. What do you say you have a look at this? Tell me what you see.
I see a whole lot of nothing. What do we got here? A broken chain, a chemical reaction, a shadow in a door frame, an oozing wound, an angry two-headed ant. An oozing wound.
Okay. How about this one?
There's a violin. Let's see, some piece of space-age technology. I'm too embarrassed to say what it looks like. Alright, good job, me. We're gonna go for a priceless work of art. Two bears high-fiving is not an answer, but it still should have been. Let's see. We're gonna go for a mushroom cloud.
Well, that's all she wrote.
If I were stuck in a situation like this, I would be throwing grenades all over the place because I wouldn't want to fucking touch anybody. But we're gonna take it off energy weapons because I don't think that's realistic. I think that my aim would be pretty shit. So let's see. We will go for melee weapons. That seems a little bit more like me. Hardy har har, bro. You are funny. So, four eyes. As most of you know, I wear glasses typically. I took them off because this way you can see my beautiful face. But so we'll go for four-eyed. Why, thank you, sir. Can I please put some pants on now? Ooh, what's over here? Pre-war books. All sorts of good shit, good shit. See, is there anything I can take from his house, though? Again, just take your dirty waters. I don't really need the empty syringe. That was kind of a screw-up. But, cherry bomb and a tire iron. Hello, doctor. Ooh,
these are yours. It was all you had on you when you was brought in.
Just got more stim caps. Stim caps, okay. I'm the best at reading.
Find the next of kin, but it was just something about a platinum chip.
Alright.
Well, if you're heading back out there, you ought to have this.
Okay.
They call it a pip boy.
Thank you.
I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through. I know what it's like having something taken from you.
I promise you're going to get his backstory later.
So the locals don't pick on you for life.
Maybe, if I remember to go to it.
It was my wife's. I think she was about your size. She hardly wore it after we left the vault. Felt it was too brazen.
Well, where is your wife, Doctor? What happened to her? All right. Thanks for patching me up, Doc.
Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for.
Here's our first thing to talk to. Victor.
Howdy, partner. Might I say
you're looking fit as a fiddle. Thanks for digging me out of that grave.
Don't mention it. I'm always ready to lend a helping hand to a stranger in need.
How did you find me?
I was out for a stroll that night when I heard the commotion up at the old bone lodge. Saw what looked like a bunch of bad eggs, so I laid low. Once they had run off, I dug you up to see if you were still kicking. Turns out you were, so I hauled you off to the dock right quick.
Hey, thanks, man. Do you know who those men were who attacked me?
I'd say that I'm familiar with the rascals. Some of the fine folks in town not here.
Cool, cool. Why are you here?
I moseyed into town only 10, 15 years ago. Before that, I can't quite seem to recall.
Cool.
It's a right peaceful town, and I reckon it's as fine a place to settle as any.
Are you telling me I should just start living here? Because, I'd be a little weird. I've never seen a robot like you before.
I'm a Securitron. Robco secured Model 26 of the day. If you ever see any of my brothers, tell them Victor says
how. Most of them aren't as personable as you, so maybe I just won't.
Happy trails!
Okay, bye! Let's see. So, we have to go find Sunny Smiles, and I'm still not trusting that name, and more pop-ups. All of those pop-ups are basically just talking about DLC, so not important reads for the game. But just so y'all know what it is I'm skipping over. And the Prospector Saloon. Fun fact, if you're out by Vegas, this saloon is actually based on a place out that way in the actual Good Springs, so it's a place you can actually kind of visit, along with the Good Springs General Store.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you?
He's one of my favorites. Do you know anything about the people who attacked me?
The one in the fancy suit seems to be calling the shots.
Benny.
As much as I know, other folks in town might know more.
Benny's gonna be my husbando.
If you ever catch up with him, watch out. Man's got cold eyes like a snake. Can't be trusted.
He's a cold-hearted snake. It's Paul Abdul, sorry. Anyways, why are you called Easy Pete?
Was a prospector until I decided to settle here to get away from the NCR. Now, I'll just take it easy and help out with the Brahmin and the big farm.
Real exciting life you got. You're a prospector, like digging for gold and silver, maybe?
Nah. Means I poked through old buildings looking for working tech and such. Some folks just call it salvaging, but never liked the term.
Okay.
The way I see it, salvage means it's broken, near worthless. Me, I look for the good stuff. Guns, canvas, spare parts, good money.
Ever floats your boat. Let's see. Cool. Bye, Pete. We got Doc's sunny smile. And her puppy. Oh, the puppy. Totally. Why not? I'm in.